Hello, welcome to netvn. In this video I show you how to create a password management server. First of all I install the operating system for the server. The operating system used in this video is Debian. You download the installer from Debian's home page. The downloaded file has the extension ISO. You then use software called Rufus to create a bootable Debian installer. You use a USB drive of at least 2 GB in size. After a few minutes you will have a bootable installer. You plug the USB stick into the target computer and start installing Debian. You access the BIOS and set up the computer to boot from the USB drive. During Debian installation, you will be asked to create a password for the root account. Then you create a new account. You write down your username and password to use in the next steps. I created a new account with username netvn and password 123. You install SSH server for remote access in the following step. And here is the Debian OS after the installation is complete. You set up a static IP address for this computer. In this case I set the IP address to 192.168.11.100. You set it up to suit the range of IP addresses you use. Then save your changes. This IP address is used for remote access within the local network. Now I use a Windows computer to access the target computer. You open a command prompt and access the target computer using SSH. You use SSH and account created during Debian installation. Then you log in with the root account. To build a password management server, I use an open source software called PassBolt. You just need to follow these steps to install PassBolt on Debian. You follow 3 steps to download the installation package PassBolt. I download the scripts file, then verify the downloaded file. Next you run the scripts file. Now you install PassBolt. You create a new database. You create a new admin password for MySQL. Then create a new database. Next you create a new account for the newly created database. You can change the database name, change the username if you want. In this case I leave the default. It makes it easier for us to follow the steps. After creating a new database, you configure the web server. Because I use in local network so I don't use encryption. Later in the video I will show how to install PassBolt using domain name and encryption. You use the server's IP address instead of using the domain name. On a Windows computer, open any browser and enter the IP address of the PassBolt server. PassBolt has completed the installation, now you configure it. You connect to the database created in the previous step. You connect to the database using the name and account created in the previous step. Next you set up OpenPGP. Then you set up to send email. In this case, I use a Gmail to send email. To use Gmail to send email, you follow these steps. With your Gmail account, you enable IMAP. Normally, Gmail accounts are authenticated with two steps, so you create a new application password. You access your Google account management. Then you create a new application password. You use this password to send emails on PassBolt. Go back to PassBolt, you set up email sending using the password just created. To make sure it works, you send a test email. I will check in my mailbox. So I received an email. It tells me everything is working fine. Next step, you are required to create a new account on PassBolt. Then you install PassBolt add-ons on your browser. It helps you to access and manage passwords with PassBolt. Next, you create a new passphrase. You save this file in a safe place to use in case you need it. After the above steps, you have completed the PassBolt. Now you can use it to manage and store your passwords. I will create a new password and store it. This is the password I just created. After you finish creating a new password, PassBolt will automatically email. You can also create an account to share with your friends. Your account and password will be sent to your friend's mailbox. Next, I use add-ons on the browser to add a new password. On Edge browser, I add my new Gmail password. You follow these steps. You will be asked to enter your password when adding a new password. As you can see, my Gmail password has been added on PassBolt. It was hosted on PassBolt. As mentioned, in this section I show you how to install PassBolt using a domain name. To get a free domain name, I use a service called DuckDNS. Because the Debian computer is on the local network and it accesses the internet through the router, I forward the port. On forwarding port 443 and port 80 on my router. DuckDNS not only provides 5 free domains but also helps you to update your dynamic public IP address. You follow the guided steps to install DuckDNS on Debian. You create a new folder named DuckDNS. In this directory, you create a new scripts file named duck.sh. You grant permission for this file to be able to run it. You then schedule this file to run using crontab. The script file is scheduled to run every 5 minutes to update your public IP address. So your domain name is always mapped with your public IP address. Your IP address update results are saved in a log file. Now you set up the domain name for PassBolt. You set up a web server with encryption. Instead of using IP address, you use domain name here. Next, you set up your email address. That way you can access the PassBolt server using the domain name. On this Windows computer, I will access the internet using a different public IP address. So two computers belong to two different internet networks. You access the PassBolt server using the domain name set up in the previous step. Access is successful. Next, you configure PassBolt the same as last time. With the domain name and encryption, you can access PassBolt using the mobile app. On PassBolt, you generate a QR code and use it to access from your phone. So I have completed the introduction of how to create a password management server. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and help me 600,000 subscribers. Good luck.